Okay, my screen is visible to everyone. This PPT
Yes,
is
sir,
visible. Yes. So, what task I have asked you in the previous lecture to complete? Very simple thing I had told. Shreya, can you tell what I had asked in the previous lecture? See, yesterday we have discussed these points, if you are able to remember. So we have seen this title of chapter, central idea of the chapter, objective, outcome, what is the meaning of model of ethical decision making process. Then what is the model which is commonly used in the ethical decision making process? Yes, which type of model is commonly used in the ethical decision making process? That we have seen yesterday. What is the name of this model? This one. So what is this model? It is known by what name? Yes. Can you give the answer? Audumbar is there?
Yes, ma'am. But me kalcha lecture no hoto, ma'am.
Okay. Then who else is there? Shreya? You were present for yesterday's lecture. What this model it is called as? What is name of this model which is explaining these four steps? What is name of this model? Anybody else? Apan discuss kelat kal he point. Why you are not able to answer? Jnaneshwari, can you give the answer? Yes, Jnaneshwari. See, if you are not answering or if you are not responding, I am going to mark your absentee. That is just not to reduce your attendance, it is for making you attentive during the lecture. Okay. So, the model of ethical decision making, it is representing the steps or it is representing the mathematical graph or architecture about how to take the proper decision for that particular situation. So while doing the business, many times the person is in the ethical dilemma. Means dilemma manje kay? Vidha manasthiti. What is good, what is right, what is wrong. So what decision should be taken by following that ethics? Kadhi kadhi ha decision ghiu ka to ghiu. Because of ethical dilemma, he may face problem in the decision making process. So under that situation, these ethical decision making models are helping the businessman to take the proper decision. That is the meaning of this ethical decision model. So ethical decision model mainly don goshti represent karta. So this additional diagram I have included. So I will just tell you that two main things are represented in the ethical decision making model. First, different steps in the ethical decision making. So what different steps are implemented in the ethical decision making? That is first thing explained in the model. And second, the different influences on that process. So I will show you this diagram. From this also you will understand how the model is representing two things. Kay represent karta pahili goshta? Kay steps ahet? Or what are the various stages in the ethical decision making process? And second, the different influences on that process. So while making the decision, which various parameters are making influence on that decision making process. So for example, if you see this diagram, so here decision making, so that decision making varti affect karnare kiwa tyachyavarti influence karnare kutle parameter ahet kiwa kutla kutla गोष्टींचा तुम्ही डिसिजन घेताना विचार करायला पाहिजे. दॅट इज शोन विथ दिस व्हाईट सर्कल्स. सो दॅट इज शेअर होल्डर्स, कस्टमर, सप्लायर, स्टाफ, कम्युनिटी. या सगळ्या गोष्टींचा तुम्ही डिसिजन घेताना विचार करायला पाहिजे. दॅट इज फर्स्ट थिंग एक्सप्लेन हिअर इन्फ्लुएन्सेस अँड सेकंड स्टेप्स इन द डिसिजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस. सो स्टेप वन इज क्लॅरिफाय, स्टेप टू इज इव्हॅल्युएट, स्टेप थ्री इज डिसाइड, फोर्थ इम्प्लिमेंट अँड फिफ्थ मॉनिटर अँड मॉडिफाय. सो स्टेजेस इन द इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस आर ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन. अँड सेकंड विच पॅरामीटर्स आर मेकिंग इन्फ्लुएन्स ऑन द डिसिजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस, दॅट इज ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन इन दिस मॉडेल. सो दिस टू थिंग्स आर मेनली रिप्रेझेंटेड. पहिली स्टेप काय आहे, तुम्हाला क्लिअर पाहिजे ऑर यू हॅव टू क्लॅरिफाय द थिंग्स. सेकंड, वन्स यू क्लॅरिफाय इट, यू हॅव टू इव्हॅल्युएट काय काय ह्याचे इफेक्ट होतील ह्या डिसिजनचे. देन थर्ड, डिसाइड, यू हॅव टू डिसाइड वॉट ऍक्शन यू हॅव टू टेक. फोर्थ, इम्प्लिमेंट. अँड फिफ्थ, वन्स यू आर इम्प्लिमेंटिंग इट यू हॅव टू मॉनिटर अँड मॉडिफाय ॲज पर द रिक्वायरमेंट. ह्या स्टेप्स दिलेल्या आहेत तिथं. आणि हे काय आहेत व्हाईट सर्कल मधले, वॉट आर दिस पॅरामीटर्स इन रिटन इन दिस व्हाईट सर्कल? कम्युनिटी, शेअर होल्डर, कस्टमर, सप्लायर, स्टाफ, वॉट दे रिप्रेझेंट फ्रॉम दिस टू डिफरंट स्टेजेस इन इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग अँड डिफरंट इन्फ्लुएन्सेस. ह्यापैकी कुठला एलिमेंट आहे तो व्हाईट सर्कल म्हणजे हे कम्युनिटी वगैरे. दॅट कम्स अंडर वॉट, अंडर दिस टू डिफरंट स्टेजेस ऑर डिफरंट इन्फ्लुएन्सेस ऑन दॅट प्रोसेस. वॉट दॅट व्हाईट सर्कल्स आर रिप्रेझेंटिंग, दॅट यू टेल मी. वेदर इट इज रिप्रेझेंटिंग डिफरंट स्टेजेस ऑर डिफरंट इन्फ्लुएन्सेस ऑन डिसिजन मेकिंग. दिस वन, वॉट इट इज रिप्रेझेंटिंग? यस, कॅन यू गिव अन्सर नाव? औदुंबर, यू आर ॲबसेंट फॉर यस्टरडेज लेक्चर. यस्टरडे वी हॅव स्टार्टेड द इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग चॅप्टर. सो दिस इज द डिसिजन मेकिंग मॉडेल, ज्याच्यामध्ये दोन गोष्टी कव्हर होतात, स्टेप्स इन द इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग अँड सेकंड विच पॅरामीटर्स आर गोइंग टू इन्फ्लुएन्स ऑन द फायनल डिसिजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस. सो आउट ऑफ दॅट दीज व्हाईट सर्कल्स आर रिप्रेझेंटिंग वॉट? वेदर द स्टेप्स फॉर डिसिजन मेकिंग ऑर द इन्फ्लुएन्सेस ऑन द डिसिजन मेकिंग? दॅट क्वेश्चन आय एम आस्किंग. सो वॉट विल बी द आन्सर फॉर दॅट? येस श्रेया, शिवानी, प्रियंका, माय व्हॉइस इज ऑडिबल टू एव्हरीवन? आर यू देअर इन द लेक्चर? येस, वेदर माय व्हॉइस इज ऑडिबल ऑर नॉट? Supriya, my voice is audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I should not expect any answers from anyone. That is the conclusion. So you are not giving responses. You are not giving answers. Many times I am asking and I am not getting response from your side. After asking so many times such a simple questions. Aishwarya, these white circles are representing what out of these two that I am asking? Different stages explain kartat te white circle ka different influences on that process, what it is representing? What it is representing?
Decision making, ma'am.
Yes, what? Who is giving answer?
Audumar.
What it is showing? I didn't understand your answer. Stages or influences? Yes, please
influences.
Repeat. Yes, correct. सो दिस हे जे आउटर आहेत ते स्टेजेस आहेत, ग्रीन कलर्ड सर्कल्स. and this white circles are representing the influences. So this is the main content of decision making model. Same it is given here that we have seen in the last lecture. And now to see the stages in the ethical decision making process, the standard model which is referred, that is known by the name as John's model. So this question it is explained, or this question it is asked in the MCQ. John's model. So that is considered as the standard model to explain any decision making process. So as per the Farrell theory, this John's model, it was invented in 1991. It provides the most comprehensive synthesis model of ethical decision making process. So याचा अर्थ काय होतो, कुठल्याही जनरली डिसिजन मेकिंग चा प्रोसेस किंवा इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग चा प्रोसेस आपण जॉन्स मॉडेल यूज करून रिप्रेझेंट करू शकतो. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू जॉन्स मॉडेल देर आर फोर स्टेप्स फॉर एनी इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग कंडिशन. सो दीज फोर स्टेप्स, ज्या स्टँडर्ड चार स्टेप्स आपण फॉलो करतो जॉन्स मॉडेल मध्ये, दोज आर: फर्स्ट इज रेकॉग्नाइज मॉरल इश्यू, सेकंड मेक मॉरल जजमेंट, थर्ड इस्टॅब्लिश मॉरल इंटेंट, अँड फोर्थ इज एंगेज इन द मॉरल बिहेवियर. ह्या चार स्टेप्स एखादं एक्झाम्पल घेऊन एक्सप्लेन करा असं मी तुम्हाला सांगितलं होतं. सो आय विल आस्क एनी वन रँडमली दिस क्वेश्चन अँड दॅट यू हॅव टू आन्सर, दॅट आय हॅव टोल्ड यू इन द प्रिव्हियस लेक्चर. ओके, सो कॅन यू गिव्ह द आन्सर, हू हॅज प्रिपेअर्ड दिस बाय टेकिंग दिस फोर स्टेप्स, हाऊ यू कॅन एक्सप्लेन एनी इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग सिच्युएशन? Yes, can anyone give the answer for this question? Are you getting what I have asked you in the previous lecture? Yes, Shreya. Have you prepared any situation? And if this situation to me, ethical decision making process. Here, char step madhe explain karu shakta ka? Kutli situation. For example, ek situation me tumhala explain keli hoti. Ki ekhada material sa production hota asta na, tyachya madhe shoddy material use karun production kela jata. And supervisor is knowing that, but still he is not taking any action. He decision making sathi mi tumhala ek situation dili hoti. He some shoddy material it is used for manufacturing of that product. Supervisor is observing that, but still no any action it is taken. So what is the steps for that decision making process? First step is recognize moral issue. So first you have to identify what is the moral issue you need to address. So काय moral issue आहे याच्यामध्ये, that the proper material it is not used for the production, that is the moral issue that you have recognized. Second, make moral judgment. So what moral judgment you can make from that? काय अर्थ काढू शकता तुम्ही त्याचे? Either that person is having casual approach, he is not sincere about his work supervisor, or the supervisor is involved with some of the competitors and so that he is intentionally ignoring it. Third, he might be getting some economical profit because of this process and so he is not doing that any action. Fourth, next you can conclude that he might be having the orders from his boss, that's why he is doing that thing. Acha judgment tumhi je kai tatun tark lavta, that is called as making the moral judgment. Then third, establish the moral intent. So in that you can decide some course of action. For example, jar tumcha judgment asel ki that person is doing it because of his casual approach, tyachyavarti tumhi kay action ghevu shakta? You can warn that person about his duty is not performed properly, If he is involved in the corruption, you can ask that person to leave the job, or you can bring it to the authority, or you can bring it to the notice of the authority. If that person is still not responding or changing, then after reporting it to the authorities, authority can ask the person to leave the job. मग हे जे काही आपले तर्क आहेत त्यानुसार आपण कोर्स ऑफ ऍक्शन इथं डिस्क्राइब करतो. फक्त इस्टॅब्लिश मॉरल इंटेंट मध्ये कोर्स ऑफ ऍक्शन आपण डिस्क्राइब करतो. म्हणजे तीन माझे जजमेंट असतील तर तीन कोर्स ऑफ ऍक्शन असतील. आणि लास्ट जे आहे एंगेज इन मॉरल बिहेवियर, म्हणजे व्हॉट इज डन इन एंगेजिंग इन मॉरल बिहेवियर, ऍक्च्युली यू आर टेकिंग दॅट पर्टिक्युलर ऍक्शन. म्हणजे एक कुठलं तरी जजमेंट आपण फायनल करून त्याच्या अकॉर्डिंगली ऍक्शन घेतली जाते. सो इफ द कन्क्लुजन इज दॅट द पर्सन इज इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द करप्शन, ऑर इफ ही इज इन्वॉल्व्ड इन सम ऑफ द कॉम्पिटिटर्स, देन डायरेक्टली द कंपनी कॅन आस्क हिम टू लीव द जॉब. सो डायरेक्ट टेकिंग ऍक्शन, दॅट इज डन इन द फोर स्टेप. सो दीज फोर स्टेप्स आर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस. सो दॅट आय हॅड आस्क यू टू एक्सप्लेन एनी सिच्युएशन बाय कन्सिडरिंग दीज फोर स्टेप्स एज अ baseline. So that task I have given you in the previous lecture. Audumbar, are you clear now what task I have given in the previous lecture? Are you?
Yes, are you?
Okay. But I am not getting any responses. Anyone has prepared this, you can just type in the chat box if you are not comfortable to talk. Let it be yes or no, you can just put your answer in the chat box. But don't hesitate to talk. Has anyone prepared? If yes, you can say yes. If no, you can say no. But at least give some response. No any answers. So I will ask 3-4 people randomly. Yes, Priyanka, have you prepared it? Priyanka Lendve. No, Rutuja, Priyanka. Okay, if not, you just take one more day. But tomorrow you have to give answer for this. At least that I can expect from you. Okay, so same thing it is given here in the description. Different stages in ethical decision making. First, recognize moral issue. काय याच्यामध्ये? It is first stage of ethical decision making. First step. It identify and recognize moral issue through investigate data, identify use or misuse of the data. Data collected from consumers. या सगळ्या डेटा मधून तुम्ही moral issue काय आहे ते find out करू शकता. That is first recognizing moral issue. Second, make moral judgment. So make moral judgment. This is second stage of ethical decision making process. It make moral judgment through gathered facts important to ethical issues. And the firm focuses on gathering facts that are important to the ethical issue, including all the relevant legal information. Ya sagle information collect karun tasa tumhi ek judgment tayar karu shakta. Okay, then establish moral intent. What it includes? It includes all the decision makers. They are coming together, they are brainstorming, they are collectively identifying the source of action and ethical decision. So action for ethical decision making. म्हणजे काय action आपण घ्यायची याची इथं चर्चा होते. That is establishing the moral intent. And fourth means this is last stage, and it choose a course of action that generates best solution and choose action using ethical practices. So these four steps are there in the ethical decision making model. So here we are completing first point of this chapter. So first point of this chapter, it is model of ethical decision making. So how to take the proper decision, that steps are also explained in this ethical model. So for this explanation, in two ways the question can be asked. First, explain the steps for ethical decision making, or explain how the or explain the steps in the John's model, or it can be asked as explain the John's model and different steps involved in that model. So like that the question can be asked. So I hope this first point is clear. Now second point we are going to start, different influences on ethical decision making. So understand this point carefully. Different influences on ethical decision making. So what do you understand from this word, different influences on ethical decision making? काय अर्थ काढता तुम्ही ह्याचा सांगा मला. Or what do you understand from this? What do you understand from this? Different influences on ethical decision making. From this term, what you can understand or what do you understand? You can write answers in the chat box also. काय असेल याच्यामध्ये सांगा मला, काय पॉइंट्स बघायचं असेल आपल्याला. Different influences on ethical decision making. So this second part we have to start of this chapter. Different influences on ethical decision making. What it might be involving? What are the various parameters that are going to influence on the decision making process? That we have to see. So under this, the first diagram, if you see, कुठल्या दोन फॅक्टर्स दिसतात इथं बघा मला. एखादा डिसिजन घेत असताना कुठल्या कुठल्या व्हेरियस पॅरामीटर्स आपल्याला कन्सिडर करावे लागतात. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, यू कन्सिडर वन सिच्युएशन दॅट सम बिझनेस इज हॅव्हिंग फायनान्शियल क्रॅशेस ऑर दॅट बिझनेस इज अंडर फायनान्शियल लॉस. मग त्या फायनान्शियल लॉस साठी एखादा डिसिजन घेत असताना तुम्हाला त्या डिसिजनचा इफेक्ट कुठल्या कुठल्या पॅरामीटरवरती होणार आहे किंवा कुणाकुणावरती त्या डिसिजनचा इफेक्ट होणार आहे, दॅट यू हॅव टू कन्सिडर. सो फॉर एक्झाम्पल, व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू टेक द डिसिजन फॉर दॅट बिझनेस लॉस, इफ यू टेक द डिसिजन दॅट यू हॅव टू रिड्यूस द मॅन पॉवर, सो इन दॅट केस एम्प्लॉई देअर फॅमिलीज विल सफर. सो व्हाइल टेकिंग डिसिजन यू हॅव टू मेक द ऑर यू हॅव टू टेक इन टू कन्सिडरेशन द एम्प्लॉईज. What will be the effect of that decision on the employees? Then next, what will be the effect of that decisions on the consumer? Suppose you suddenly increase the cost of the product for your financial profit, then consumers will be having problem because of that. And again, if the cost is more, you will not get the more consumers. Then if you take the decision to stop that product, that will be also problematic. Or you can think about the choice that you can merge your company, you can collaborate your company with some other some of your competitor and combinedly you can work. So like that, जेव्हा आपण एखाद्या decision चं brainstorming करत असतो तेव्हा you have to consider what is the effect of that decision on each and every stakeholder of the company related to decision. That is one thing. And then also, when the decision is taken, what different influences are there, किंवा कुठल्या कुठल्या गोष्टींचा त्या डिसिजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस वरती इफेक्ट होतो, दॅट वी हॅव टू सी. सो देर आर मेनली टू फॅक्टर्स दॅट वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर इन द इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग इन्फ्लुएन्सेस. फर्स्ट इज इंडिव्हिज्युअल इन्फ्लुएन्सेस ऑर इंडिव्हिज्युअल फॅक्टर, अँड सेकंड इट इज द situational influences or situational factors. So mainly these two things are affecting on the ethical decision making process. You can see these arrows. Ya factors cha output hecha input la dilele, mhanje ha factor ya sagya process varti affect hoto. Individual factor will affect on this decision making process, also situational factors will affect on the ethical decision making process. That is meaning of this particular diagram. So we have to see the two main factors. Ata apan tyatle paras sub part baghuya. Apan adi don kutle influences consider karayche ethical decision making madhe, either the individual factors or the situational factors. So that are going to affect on the ethical decision making process. So models of ethical decision making generally divide the factors which influence that decision making model into two broad categories, individual and situational. Okay, so what are the individual factors, or what you understand from individual factors? आता एखादा डिसिजन घेताना हे चार स्टेप्स आहेत. रेकॉग्नाइज मॉरल इश्यू, मेक मॉरल जजमेंट, इस्टॅब्लिश. आता इंडिव्हिज्युअल फॅक्टर म्हणजे काय? पर्सन टू पर्सन द पर्स्पेक्टिव्ह कॅन बी डिफरंट. मग एखाद्याचा इंडिव्हिज्युअल पर्सनॅलिटीचा किंवा एखाद्याच्या इंडिव्हिज्युअल वॉट वी कॅन से वॉट एव्हर इज द इंडिव्हिज्युअल टेंडन्सी ऑफ दॅट पर्सन. Or every person is having different characteristics or different human values. So whatever are the individual human values, those are also going to affect on this decision making process. That is called as individual factors. And is situational factor manje kay? Under the various situation or under the different situations, the decision making may be changed. So under what situation you are taking that decision, that is also going to affect on that decision making process. That is called as the situational factors. Okay, are you getting what is the meaning of these two factors, individual factors and situational factors? Yes, can anyone give the answer for this? What is meaning of individual and what is the situational? Yes. Can you give the answer for this? Yes, continue.
Hello, ma'am. The situational factor, repeat kara thoda sa.
What?
Situational factors, repeat kara ma'am.
Okay. See, these points we are going to see in detail. Personal, individual madhe pan kai sub points ahet. Situation madhe sudha sub points ahet. But for example, for this situational factor, पॉइंट मेन समजलं तुम्हाला, ह्याचा अर्थ काय? इन्फ्लुएन्सेस ऑन इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग. म्हणजे एखादा इथिकल डिसिजन घेत असताना कुठले फॅक्टर्स त्याच्यावरती परिणाम करतात. इन्फ्लुएन्स म्हणजे काय? प्रभाव असणे. कुठल्या गोष्टींचा त्याच्यावरती इफेक्ट होतो, दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज इन्फ्लुएन्सेस ऑन इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग. मग पहिला आहे इंडिव्हिज्युअल फॅक्टर्स. द पर्सन हु इज गोइंग टू टेक द डिसिजन, दॅट पर्सन इज हॅव्हिंग various properties. For example, if A and B are two people, individually they are different people or they are different persons, so their individual influence also affect on the ethical decision making process. That like emotional asu shakto, ek tatla rational asu shakto. If that person is emotional, he may take the different steps or his perspective can be different while following these steps. If that person is professional, his decisions will also affect in another way on the ethical decision making process. हा झाला इंडिव्हिज्युअल फॅक्टर. इंडिव्हिज्युअल फॅक्टर लक्षात आला का उदुंबर? सपोज एखादा डिसिजन आपण घेतोय आणि तोच डिसिजन जर एखादी मोठी व्यक्ती घेत असेल तर इंडिव्हिज्युअली दॅट इज गोइंग टू अफेक्ट ऑन द डिसिजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस. वी मे हॅव इन्फ्लुएन्स ऑफ इमोशन्स. Age factor we have to consider in individual factor, men and women. So individual personality is different and that's why that's also effect of the ethical decision making madhe tela mantat individual factor. Individual factor is clear, Audumbar?
Yes, individual, I'm clear.
Now when we say the situational factor manje suppose you have to consider the two different situations. आता एखाद्या प्रोडक्ट साठी किंवा एखाद्या प्रोडक्ट बद्दल डिसिजन घेताना यू कन्सिडर द टू सिच्युएशन. वन सिच्युएशन इज द प्रॉफिट इज मोर, किंवा तो प्रोडक्ट मार्केटमध्ये चांगला जास्त सेल होतोय अँड दॅट यू आर गेटिंग द प्रॉफिट. दॅट इज वन सिच्युएशन. सो इन दॅट सिच्युएशन युअर डिसिजन्स विल बी डिफरंट. प्रोडक्शन बद्दल असू द्या किंवा कशाबद्दल असू द्या, युअर डिसिजन्स विल बी डिफरंट. अगेन यू कन्सिडर द अनदर सिच्युएशन दॅट प्रोडक्शन किंवा त्याचा जो सेल आहे तो कमी झालेला आहे प्रोडक्टचं मार्केटमध्ये. इफ यू कन्सिडर दॅट सिच्युएशन दॅट इज गोइंग टू चेंज युअर डिसिजन इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर बिझनेस. म्हणजे सिच्युएशन चेंज झाली की त्या सिच्युएशनचा इफेक्ट त्या डिसिजन मेकिंग प्रोसेसमध्ये होतो. दॅट इज द मिनिंग ऑफ दिस सिच्युएशनल पॅरामीटर. सो दिस सिम्पल एक्झाम्पल्स आय एम गिव्हिंग. किंवा जेव्हा कस्टमर तुमच्या फेवरमध्ये असतात और वेन युअर प्रोडक्ट इज व्हेरी लाईक्ड बाय द कस्टमर्स दॅट इज वन सिच्युएशन. अनदर दुसरं काहीतरी मार्केटमध्ये चांगलं आलंय आणि तुमचं प्रोडक्ट कस्टमरला आवडेना झाला आधीसारखा दॅट इज अनदर सिच्युएशन. मग त्याची कॉस्ट किती ठेवायची हा डिसिजन जर तुम्हाला घ्यायचा असेल तर सिच्युएशननुसार तो डिसिजन बदलणार आहे. आर यू गेटिंग दॅट पॉइंट? अंडर द प्रॉफिट कंडिशन जर प्रॉफिट खूप होत आहे तर तुम्ही डिसिजन घेऊ शकता आपण 1-5 रुपये कॉस्ट त्या प्रोडक्टची वाढवली तरी कस्टमर घेतील. बट इफ द सिच्युएशन इज दॅट द पीपल आर नॉट मोर लाईकिंग इट ॲज पर द प्रिव्हियस, आधीसारखा तो प्रोडक्ट त्यांना आवडत नाहीये, त्याचा सेल कमी झालाय किंवा त्याची खरेदी कस्टमर कडून कमी झाली आहे, तर ह्या सिच्युएशन मध्ये तुम्ही कॉस्ट वाढवून उपयोग होईल का त्याचा? अंडर दॅट सिच्युएशन विल इट बी हेल्पफुल टू इन्क्रीज द कॉस्ट? नो. सो वॉट आर द सिच्युएशन्स? दॅट सिच्युएशन्स आर गोइंग टू अफेक्ट ऑन द डिसिजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस. त्याला म्हणतात सिच्युएशनल फॅक्टर्स. आर यू गेटिंग द बेसिक कन्सेप्ट? औदुंबर इज इट क्लिअर नाव? औदुंबर सिच्युएशनल फॅक्टर्स. ओके. सो इन पर्सनल इन्फ्लुएन्सेस और दोज आर कॉल्ड एज इंडिव्हिज्युअल फॅक्टर्स. सो दीज आर युनिक कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द इंडिव्हिज्युअल ऍक्च्युअली मेकिंग द रिलेव्हंट डिसिजन. दीज इन्क्लूड फॅक्टर्स विच आर गव्हर्न बाय बर्थ सच एज एज अँड जेंडर. तर बघा आपलं एज सुद्धा अफेक्ट करतं. सो द डिसिजन हु इज गोइंग टू वॉट एव्हर इज गोइंग टू बी टेकन बाय सम यंग पर्सन अँड सेम डिसिजन इफ इट हॅज टू बी टेकन बाय सम पर्सन हु इज ऑफ मोर एज दॅट इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू अफेक्ट. मग ह्याच्यामध्ये काय इंडिव्हिज्युअल मध्ये मेन एज फॅक्टर, जेंडर फॅक्टर अँड दोज अक्वायर्ड बाय एक्सपिरियन्स अँड सोशलायझेशन सच एज एज्युकेशन. एखाद्या एज्युकेशन असणाऱ्या पर्सनने डिसिजन घेणं आणि एखाद्या इलिटरेट पर्सनने एज्युकेशन एखादा डिसिजन घेणं दॅट इज गोइंग टू अगेन मेक द डिफरंट डिसिजन्स. ओके. सो पर्सनॅलिटी, ऍटिट्यूड्स हे इंडिव्हिज्युअल फॅक्टर झाले. सिच्युएशनल फॅक्टर्स काय आहेत बघा? दीज आर द पर्टिक्युलर फीचर्स ऑफ द कंटेक्स्ट दॅट इन्फ्लुएन्स वेदर द इंडिव्हिज्युअल विल मेक अन इथिकल ऑर अनइथिकल डिसिजन. दिस इन्क्लूड फॅक्टर्स असोसिएटेड विथ द वर्क कंटेक्स्ट सच एज रिवॉर्ड सिस्टीम, जॉब रोल अँड ऑर्गनायझेशनल कल्चर. वेन द सिच्युएशन इज चेंजिंग इफ यू कन्सिडर टू डिफरंट ऑर्गनायझेशन्स देअर द सिच्युएशन मे बी डिफरंट अँड बेस्ड ऑन दॅट द डिसिजन कॅन बी चेंज अँड ऑल्सो दोज असोसिएटेड विथ द इश्यू इट सेल्फ सच एज इंटेन्सिटी ऑफ द मॉरल इश्यू or ethical framing of this issue. So these two main factors are there which are making its effect on the ethical decision making. Okay, so that first you have to keep in mind. Main adhi don influences lakshat thevayche, individual factors ani situational influences. Now we will see what are the sub points under this individual factor. This basic concept is clear to everyone? Yes, Shreya, is it clear? What are two main parameters which are going to influence on the decision making? Shefali, is it clear? Yes. Clear or not? The basic concept here.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we will see the sub points which are there in the individual influences on ethical decision making. So individual influences on ethical decision making relate to these packets of the individual who is actually going through the decision making process. So decision घेणारा person बदलला की त्याचा effect the decision making process वरती होतो. Clearly, all employees bring certain traits and characteristics with them into an organization, and these are likely to influence the way in which the employee thinks and behaves in response of ethical dilemma. Okay, so the unique characteristics of individual actually making the relevant decision. Pratyekache characteristics manje pratyekache nature that is different. Their personal abilities are different, so that is going to affect on the decision. Okay, so individual influences madhe kutle kutle sub point ahet baka. First is age and gender. So what are the usual assumptions that also are given in this point? Aged people are more ethical than young people. So that is one assumption. Okay, asha vegvegla theory ahet jyacha madhe एक्सपेरिमेंटल एनालिसिस करू. ओके, ज्याच्यामध्ये एक्सपेरिमेंटल एनालिसिस करून दॅट थिंग्स आर ऑर सम स्टेटमेंट्स आर मेड की एजचा जर आपण विचार केला तर त्या थेअरीनुसार काय आहे किंवा एक्सपेरिमेंटल रिझल्ट नुसार एजेड पीपल ऑर ओल्डर पीपल आर मोर इथिकल दॅन द यंग पीपल. सो इफ सम young person is going to make the decision and if some old person is going to take some that same decision, then it can be more ethical by the aged person or old person. Then another assumption, it is females are more ethical than men, or that is another principle. If you consider the gender, personal influences bagto apan kiwa individual influences madhe एज मध्ये काय सांगितलंय की द एजड पीपल आर मोर इथिकल दॅन यंग पीपल, दॅन फिमेल्स आर मोर इथिकल दॅन मेन. दॅट इज अनदर अझम्पशन व्हॉट इज मेड. सो फर्स्ट थिंग एज अँड जेंडर हा पहिला इन्फ्लुएन्स फॅक्टर झाला. सेकंड नॅशनल अँड कल्चरल कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरंट कल्चरल बॅकग्राऊंड लाईकली टू हॅव डिफरंट बिलीफ्स अबाउट राईट अँड wrong, different values. For example, आता एखादा decision आहे. So the decision maker is from Maharashtra. And another, for the same situation, if the decision maker is from Karnataka. So their cultural values are different, their cultural backgrounds are different, their beliefs are different. And based on that, the decisions can be changed. मग सेकंड इंडिव्हिज्युअल इन्फ्लुएन्स कशाचा आहे? नॅशनल आणि कल्चरल कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक. सो पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरंट कल्चरल बॅकग्राऊंड दे हॅव डिफरंट बिलीफ्स अबाउट व्हॉट इज राईट व्हॉट इज रॉंग अँड देअर कोर व्हॅल्यूज आर ऑल्सो डिफरंट अँड दॅट विल अगेन लीड टू द व्हेरिएशन्स इन द इथिकल डिसिजन मेकिंग अक्रॉस नेशन्स अँड कल्चर्स. ओके, दॅट इज अनदर थिंग दॅट यू हॅव टू कन्सिडर. ओके, देन पहिलं आहे एज आणि जेंडर, देन सेकंड नॅशनल अँड कल्चरल कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक. सो दीज आर द इंडिव्हिज्युअल इन्फ्लुएन्स. सो ऑल्सो वी हॅव टू सी दॅट इंडिव्हिज्युअल इन्फ्लुएन्सेस इन डिटेल, सम मोर इन्फ्लुएन्सेस. सो जस्ट अ मिनिट, आय विल शेअर सम अनदर पीपीटी विथ यू. बघा इथं इंडिव्हिज्युअल सी individual influences, age and gender. Research suggests that aged people are more ethical than young, female are more ethical than men. These are individual influences. National and cultural characteristics. People from different cultural backgrounds likely to have different beliefs about right and wrong. So they have the different values as their moral values, and they can take the different decision based on their culture or their beliefs about right and wrong. As well as second individual influence, so same it is given here explanation. So here when they are comparing men and women, it is given here. So just a minute. I will just explain the key highlight point. So the findings suggest that women have a stronger emotional aversion to causing harm than men. So whenever the product or the, as they are, women are emotional. So that is scientific theory that is showing these variations between the genders. Nature of woman and nature of men, how it is differing. So they are having stronger emotional aversion to causing harm than men. मग काही ठिकाणी जर डिसिजन घ्यायची वेळ आली तर as the women are emotional, more emotional than men, the decisions can be accordingly changed. Okay. So that is the thing here. Again, women are more likely to have a gut level negative reaction to causing harm to an individual when men experience less emotional responses to doing harm. Okay, so when it comes to the security, they are more emotional as compared with the man. That is some of the conclusions from the scientific theories or from scientific experiments. So like that, they have explained. So these first two things you consider, age and gender. Then second, national and cultural characteristics. हे सुद्धा प्रत्येकाचे वेगळे असतात, त्यामुळे पर्सन टू पर्सन इट कॅन बी चेंज. देन थर्ड पॅरामीटर हिअर इट इज एज्युकेशन अँड एम्प्लॉयमेंट. सो फॉर एक्झाम्पल, इफ अ पर्सन हु इज हायली एज्युकेटेड इज गोइंग टू टेक सम डिसिजन अँड द इलिटरेट पर्सन इज गोइंग टू टेक द डिसिजन, ऑब्विसली दॅट इज गोइंग टू बी चेंज because the knowledge level of their education or educated person is more, so the decision making capability is also more. But sometimes based on experience that can be reverse also. Ekada business madhe ekada manus just experienced asel, though he is having less education but he is having more experience about that situations, he may take the more proper decision as compared with the more educated person, like that. So it depends based on the particular two things, education and employment. So educated people are more ethical than the illiterate. So for that they have given one example, but here you have to just remember this one sentence: educated people are more ethical than the illiterate people. So when the decision making time comes, that may be more ethical for the educated person. Okay, but relationship between employment, experience and education and ethical decision making is still unclear. So this is one general statement that is made. Okay, if educated person can take proper decision, but still the relation between education, employment and decision making, that is still unclear. That is the last statement given here. Then next, psychological factors. Individual factor madhe chautha point ahe psychological. Pahile don kutle baghitle apan individual madhe, age and gender. Second, cultural and national characteristics. Third, we have seen education and employment, and this fourth is psychological factors. So everybody's psychology is different. So now we will not see these terms actually now, but you just try to understand each person is having different psychology, or their logic or their psychological thinking or way of thinking is different. So psychological factors also are important subpart of the individual factors. So cognitive moral development refers to different levels of reasoning that an individual can apply. So different levels of reasoning that individual can apply to ethical issues and the problems. So based on these levels, the psychological levels are also going to change, and based on that the ethical decision making process also changes. So if that person is having some good psychology, that ethical, it is more followed. If it is having some abnormalities in the psychological thinking, then the possibility of ethical decision making, it is reduced. Okay, that is psychological factors. Then fifth, personal integrity. So we will see these terms also, but this we will see in the next lecture, these terms. Fifth is personal integrity. Integrity means what? Honesty. Pratyekachi personal integrity vegli aste. Some are more honest about their job, about their work. Some people, they are just working for sake of convenience. जेवढं कामापुरतं आहे तेवढंच करायचं. सम पीपल आर प्रोएक्टिव्ह, दे आर व्हेरी इंटिग्रेटेड विथ देअर ऑर्गनायझेशन, व्हेरी ऑनेस्टली दे आर परफॉर्मिंग द ड्युटीज. सो इंटिग्रिटी इज डिफाइंड एज एन अधेरन्स टू मॉरल प्रिन्सिपल्स ऑर व्हॅल्यूज. जे लोक प्रामाणिक असतात, ज्यांची पर्सनल इंटिग्रिटी जास्त असते, ऑब्विसली दे आर गोइंग टू मेक द डिसिजन्स, द डिसिजन्स विल बी इथिकल. अदरवाइज इफ पर्सनल इंटिग्रिटी इज लेस and that person is going to take the decision, whether that decision will be more ethical or less ethical, their personal integrity kami asel, tar the decision taken by that personal person will be more ethical or less ethical, that I am asking. Sangha mala, who will take the more ethical decision? पर्सनल इंटिग्रिटी जास्त असणारा पर्सन घेईल का कमी असणारा घेईल?
मोर.
सो द ओरिजिनल मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड इज कन्सर्न्ड विथ युनिटी अँड होलनेस. वन मेंटेन्स कन्सिस्टन्सी ऑफ युनिटी इन वन बिलीफ्स अँड ऍक्शन्स रिगार्डलेस ऑफ एनी इंड्युसमेंट ऑर टेम्पटेशन टू डेव्हिएट फ्रॉम देम. प्रामाणिकपणे काम करणे, that is integrity. Then personal values. So personal values of every person is different, that's why that is going to affect on the decision making process. Personal values is an enduring belief that a specific mode of conduct or end state of existence is personally or socially preferable. So all these six points are there, which comes under the individual influences: age and gender, national and cultural characteristics, education and development, psychological factors, and personal integrity and personal values. हे सगळे इंडिव्हिज्युअल फॅक्टर्स आहेत. जसं पर्सन बदलला की तो पर्टिक्युलर डिसिजन इथिकल असेल का नाही, दॅट लेवल ऑल्सो चेंजेस. दॅट इज द इंडिव्हिज्युअल इन्फ्लुएन्सेस. And situational influences that we will see in the next lecture. So are you clear with that first thing at least? Individual influences, are you clear with that? Yes, Audumbar?
Yes, ma'am, clear.
So we will stop here. I hope that task, at least whatever I have told, you will make that task up to the next lecture.